8 things the all-electric Toyota Tacoma won't have. You ever think about the things that the electric Toyota Tacoma won't have? You know, 8 things that are going to disappear. You know, it kind of reminds me of some of the things of the past, right? And some of you guys and gals may remember these things, and some of you may not, but do you remember the vinyl record? Everybody remembers vinyl records, right? You ever played one? You ever owned one? What about a VHS tape? You know, used to go in the old VCR. Do you remember those? Have you ever used them? How about a dial phone? You know, where you had to turn the dial on the phone. I saw a video a while back, somebody handed a young person a dial phone and asked them to make a call, and they didn't know how to operate it. They even tried to push the numbers in the dial. It was funny. Music cassettes, remember those? How about floppy disks? What about beepers and pagers? All gone. Well, here are 8 things that are going to disappear, that will be gone from the all-electric Toyota Tacoma. First off, the stick shift. Now, I'm talking about the manual transmission, and for that matter, the stick shift, the shifter itself at all, just the automatic, that's going to be gone. Because like the Tesla, it's going to be push button of some sort. Might even be on the screen. You might just touch the screen. D for drive, R for reverse, N for neutral, and P for park. That's it. No more shifter in the center console area. The benefit, you'll have more room, I guess. What about a keyhole? Or even a push start button? You know, I think that's all gonna go away. You'll have a fob still. You'll put it in your pocket. That will activate the system, if you will. So you'll walk up, if it's like the Tesla, the door handles will pop out. You'll open your door, shut your door, get in, and the system's ready. It's ready to go. As soon as you select the gear via that touch screen or push button, you'll be able to move. The gas pedal. The gas pedal is going to be gone. You know, in the future, when you talk to somebody about, yeah, when I used to push on the gas pedal, they won't have any idea what you're talking about. Now, the accelerator pedal, which I guess is what we're going to have to call it, will still be there, but no more gas pedal. It'll disappear, at least the terminology anyway. How about spark plugs or any other spark ignition system? No need for that in an all-electric car, right? It's charged, it's ready to go all the time. You don't need spark plugs. That'll be gone. Air cleaners, cold air intake, that'll be gone. You're not feeding anything into the engine, right? No gas, no air, you don't need any of that. That'll be gone. Mufflers or catalytic converters and tailpipes. All of that stuff is going to be gone. And look at the weight reduction we've got here, right? We're taking all these things out. You would think the cost of not having all of these extra things that you need for a gas-powered engine would offset the cost of electrics, right? I don't know. Gas fillers and gas tanks. You won't have any more of those. When you talk to a person, I don't know, maybe 30, 40, 50 years, whatever from now, when you talk to them about going up and sticking the gas nozzle in the gas tank and filling up your tank, they're not going to have any idea what you're talking about. You might as well talk about those old washers that you had to do by hand, right? I've never even seen those. You know, those old, like, files, I guess, that you ran your clothes across in the water to wash them. It's going to be the same kind of thing, I think. Fuel lines and fuel pumps. There is no more fuel, right? You're not feeding anything from what will be a non-existent gas tank into an engine. That stuff's going to be gone. And the biggest thing of all, and the thing that we'll probably all miss the most, the engine. That great big giant thing, you know, it sits here right now under your hood. And I'm talking to the people 30, 40, 50 years from now. You know, that thing that used to sit right here, the thing that used to make your car or truck go, that'll be gone. There won't be any more engine under this hood. It's going to be storage space. It's going to be the front trunk. That's what it's going to be for. It's going to give you more room to haul stuff. Of course, you don't want to put a bunch of weight in those electric vehicles because then you're going to see that charge go down even faster, right? But it'll be gone. The engine will be gone. It will be replaced by wheel motors. You're going to have four motors, most likely, one on each wheel. That's going to be charged or connected to the charging system or the batteries, if you will. That's what's going to drive the truck. There isn't going to be any engine underneath the hood. We won't be able to go out and do anything. All those tools and things that you have, you're not going to need them. And that's another thing that's going to disappear. You know, the days when you go out in your garage and you have that big toolbox, I happen to have one right here. It's not a huge one, but it is a toolbox, and it's got all my wrenches and screwdrivers and pliers and all that stuff in it. You're not going to need that anymore because you're not going to be able to do anything. I mean, what are you going to do? Go out and rip your wheel motor apart? I doubt it. You're not going to add cold air intakes. They're going to be gone. You're not going to put aftermarket exhausts on. They're going to be gone. You might put a speaker on because I imagine in the future, at some point, they'll probably be sound enhanced vehicles, right? So that when you push on the get or the accelerator pedal, you'll actually get some sound. It'll probably be piped through speakers to the outside so that people can hear you coming, right? I mean, they have to do something. There's already been a lot of talk about electric vehicles being so silent that people can't hear them. And I believe they have added some sound to some of them so that people are alerted when there's one around so they don't step out in front of it. I can see the day when there are speakers located somewhere in the truck, or probably be a digital sound creation device that emits some sort of a V8 kind of grumble or sound. And won't that be wild? Could you imagine pulling up next to a Tesla and it's sitting there going, brum, 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 brum. I mean, can you imagine what that would be like? It'd be crazy, right? There are stranger things out there and I can see it coming. So anyway, those are just eight things the all-electric Toyota Tacoma is not going to have. They're going to be gone. And years from now, like today, when you talk to kids and tell them about things that maybe you had when you were young, and they have that blank look on their face, they have no idea what you're talking about, it's going to be the same thing when you're talking about these things. I don't know. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think. If I missed anything, what else do you imagine is going to be gone? Obviously, there'll be no gas gauge, right? You won't need that. It'll be gone. It'll probably be replaced by an electric charge gauge. And it probably won't even be a gauge, honestly. It'll be a number on your gauge cluster or on your big giant screen, like the Tesla, that shows you where your charge is. Who knows? Also, real quick, if you haven't before, check out my other channel. It is Robmotive JT, all about my dyno-powered Jeep Gladiator. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.